pilots, this is Overkill. Bringing you course 4 for basic fundamentals F-15C, landing VFR or visual flight rules. Okay, in today's course we'll be going over how to land the aircraft strictly by looking out the window. We're not going to do any of the instruments today. So the first thing we want to do is we want to get to about 1500 feet above the deck. Okay, now what that's the easy way to do that, we'll pause this, hit F10, move our mouse, go ahead and take our ruler off, move our mouse just over the runway. Okay, I know you guys can't see my cursor, but it's currently over the runway at Tbilisi. We're going to look at the top left of our screen where it says longitude and latitude, and at the far right of that we can see our altitude. So 1574 feet is the deck on the runway. So we're going to come down to approximately 3,000 feet for the approach. Okay, so unpausing. We're also going to start reducing our speed. We want to get down to about 200 knots. Now, as far as landing speeds, this is all based on your weight, guys. I know a lot of people say, oh, it's 150, it's 160, it's 170, whatever it may be. It's based on your weight. Now, 150, 160, that's a good reference point to start with. Okay, but as far as the actual landing speed, it's going to be based on your weight. All right, so once we get down to 3,000 feet, we'll go ahead and start the approach. Line up. We're going to go ahead and use our air brake with Bravo and slow us down to about 200 knots. We're at zero throttle right now because we're so light. We've got a clean aircraft. We have a full tank of gas, but that's really the only weight we have at the moment. We can hit our flaps below 240 knots, so yellow indication for flaps. Let's make sure all of our lights are on. Right control, right alt Lima, anti-collision, right control navigation. Okay, we're at 3,000 feet now. What we're going to do is we're going to move the VVI right to the threshold of the runway. See what we're doing there? And you can use the threshold of the runway. I typically use the piano keys, the big white square boxes. Okay. We're going to start accelerating. We want to hold about 180 knots, somewhere in that range for the moment. Go ahead and bring the landing gear down with a gamma. Let's check our landing light. So left or right alt Lima twice. Oh, came off course a bit, so we get for going to the external cameras. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and power up a bit. I'm going to level it out just a second. Got a little low, a little too fast. Okay, and this is all about eyeball, guys, so, I mean, understand your glide slope. We will be looking for, you see AOA in the bottom left of the HUD. We're looking for about 21 to 23 units of AOA at touchdown with about a 3-degree approach, so that's what we're at right now. Let's start reducing our speed to about 170 knots. I'm adding power. If I start nosing up, I'm reducing power. I just want to hold it right about there. Right at touchdown, I'm going to hit the air brake. It says spoiler to prevent bouncing. Okay, so I'm going to pitch up. Look for that 23 units. There it is. Air brake. There it is. We're going to hold the nose wheel up, zero throttle, but we're holding the nose up. This is called aerodynamic braking, using the fuselage of the aircraft to slow her down. Still keeping that air brake up. At about 100 knots, the nose wheel should come down. We're going to hold left alt Quebec. Disengage the nose wheel steering once it touches down. So there it is. Left alt Quebec is down. Slowly start applying our wheel brakes. If you start wandering, reduce lift one wheel brake versus the other and sort of feather it back and forth. Just like that. And welcome to Tbilisi, guys. I know that was short and dirty. I hope you guys caught something from it. I highly recommend watching this. If you are watching it again, pay attention to the HUD as I'm talking. Now, when I say by the HUD, look at my airspeed and look at my altitude rate, okay? You can use your vertical velocity indicator, the center gauge down here underneath the altimeter. You want to keep that under 100 units, okay, of descent. Anything faster than that, and you're going to come down like a piano. The ideal spot, the sweet spot, is about 50 units of, or 50 feet, or, God, I can't talk, sorry, guys, 500 feet per minute. So right between 0 and 1 is where you want to keep that gauge when you're on your landing approach. You want about 500 feet per minute. Anything faster than that, and you may bounce or blow a tire, just come down, like a piano and make a lot of noise and smoke, okay, which I can tell you is bad for your health. Aside from that, keep practicing, guys. If you have any other questions, as usual, please leave them in the comments below. I'll be happy to go over this again if I need. Until then, keep flying, guys, and we'll talk to you next time. Hit that like button.